Would you like to be queen for a day?
Removes any excess condensation that builds up. Water doesn't. And This is in the open position.
Yeah.
Forward
and open. Right here, this is the reverser. It controls the direction of the locomotive. So all the way forward is forward, all the way back is back. We're in kind of a neutral position right now. As we get moving, we'll move it a little bit up to about this position right here. It works sort of kind of like the manual transmission on a car. All the way forward is like first gear, where we're relying purely on the volume of steam. And as we hook it up, it's going to shorten the stroke of the piston, and that'll rely more on the expense of power of steam, save Nick from doing a heck of a lot of work. And so we'll make his job a little easier by bringing it a little closer to center.
Okay.
Over here, these are our brake stands. This is the automatic brake. This would control a train. We don't have one behind us, so we're not going to worry about that. This is the independent. This just does the locomotive. So right now I've got it in the set position. This is like a parking brake, just holding us in place. Now, if you look over here, you'll see a notch right here.
Yep.
This is called release. There's a little notch right here. As you bring it over that notch, you're in apply. And then if you bring it back right up against that notch on this side, that'll hold it. And so this red needle on that gauge right there shows how much brake pressure we have to put on.
Okay, take that with me.
This one right here,
okay?
That's the only one of all these needles you need to worry about. This red needle right here. We don't want to do. But as you see, I hold it over against that set position, and it's going to increase our pressure in the brakes, and I release it, and it'll drop back down to zero. Now you'll notice it's not going to start picking up until we're at about 10 pounds. So don't wait for it to get to 10 pounds, because at that point you're already going to be past that. But so we're just going to take a little bit of a time, just take some, bring it back over to the set position, take a little more if we need it, hold it. And the nice thing with just the locomotive is we can tap it just a little bit over that hump and knock some of it off. So if we take too much, we can release just a little bit. So when the pressure is going up there, it's air assisted, so once you get it moving, it'll go on its own. It's tough to get moving, but then once you've got it moving, it'll work with you. Yeah, take it all the way forward.
You may have to refill that cup.
Yeah. All right, now bring it all the way back. And see, once you get it going and hear that noise, it'll go with you. Beautiful.
Alright.
This right here is our whistle. You paid a lot of money for this. Get your money's worth on the whistle. Blow it long, blow it loud. You know your grace clause is
long, long, short, long.
So the long, most of the people that do this, if they do a long, you would call a short. Your long should be at least 3 to 4 seconds. 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes. And doing that sequence, leave a little bit of space in between your whistle flaps. A, it helps time it where you get more time to the crossing. B, we're in the mountains, you can hear the echo. It sounds real good.
Yeah.
And so, the last thing, this is our throttle. The throttle has a dead zone. Bring it up to here, we're not doing anything. Here it gets stiff. You'll have to use both hands to pull it back. We're going to go one notch at a time on these gear teeth. This locomotive is very powerful. It's built to haul a 20 to 30 car train. We don't have anything behind us. So one notch at a time is all we're ever going to use. And so it'll actually push out on you when you open it. I didn't pull it out like that. So just be mindful of that. And so right now we've got our shoulder cocks open. The reverse is centered in the brake set. So the throttle is just going to send steam out the side. So go ahead and grab that and pull it out to where it gets stiff. It'll get real stiff on you.
Okay.
There you go.
All right.
And then take it out one more notch. Okay, right there. One more. Okay. One more.
What are we trying to get through?
In a minute, we'll hear the steam go up the cylinder top. have the Snickers up yet.
Okay.
Come out one more.
There you go. Hear that steam? Yep. That means there's steam going through the throttle and it's applying power. And we'll sit there for a second. Should get us moving.
Tiny bit.
And we're moving.
Yep.
So that's all it takes is just that one knot. If you were to come out more than that, we'd split the driver.
Okay.
So you can go ahead and close the cylinder top.
Come out one more on the throttle. And then we're going to practice using our brake. If we're on flat track, we're going to use the throttle to simulate if we were going down grade. So on your brake, you go ahead and take a small set. Come over that hump a little bit more to the right. Up against the pinch knob right here. And then back to the knob right here. Feeling slowing down?
Yep.
You can see that we've got about 11, 12 pounds. Go ahead and release that to the left. Yep. And then take another set. Take a little more.
Thank you.
wanted to do was blow the whistle. I didn't know that I could drive.
Yeah.
And I found out.
Thank you. connector 81 to engine 81. Permission to go between, over.
Permission granted, connector 81 out. I'm going up there, Bill. Okay. Making sure. You want to take these guys inside, you can.
Okay.
It's been a pleasure, gentlemen.